Well, welcome to Wednesday morning's devotions. This week, we're thinking about what it means to be a people who are sent out into the world to live and talk out our faith. The church, of course, is both a gathered community and a sent community. And we're basing what we're thinking about this week on the model of mission that Jesus laid down in Acts chapter 1 and verses 1 to 8. Let me read that again this morning. In my formula book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus began to do and to teach until the day he was taken up to heaven after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles he had chosen. After his suffering, he showed himself to these men and gave many convincing proofs that he was alive. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days and spoke about the kingdom of God. On one occasion, while he was eating with them, he gave them this command: "Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak about. For John baptized you with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." So when they met together, they asked him, "Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel?" He said to them, "It's not for you to know the times or dates the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth." On Monday, we thought about what it meant to be sent into Jerusalem to show and to tell of the love of Jesus among our own. Yesterday, we thought about Judea as the wider community, perhaps where we work or we hang out with our not yet Christian friends. Today, it's Samaria. So who are the Samaritans for us? Samaritans, of course, were hated by the Jews. They were considered to be way beyond the mercy and love of God. Outsiders, with no hope and no access to the things of God. The reasons behind that were historical, but also cultural and indeed racist. So who are the Samaritans for us? Those that we hold strong views about. Those that we might dismiss as scroungers or worse. Those that we feel have no place in our community or even our country. Those who get our backs up. Those we ignore or speak against. Those who, even though we wouldn't say it directly, have no place, as far as we're concerned, in God's heart and desires. Those, in other words, that we write off. Now that's something to think about. Let me suggest some people or people groups that we might just want to have an honest think about. Asylum seekers, people on benefits, people with additional needs, the homeless, alcoholics, drug users, Palestinians, Jews, Muslims, bankers, and so it goes on and on. There may well be plenty of people who might qualify as Samaritans for us. The important question is, among all of those and others that you can think of, who does actually qualify as a Samaritan for you? For the early church, this was one of the great challenges they faced. Jesus, of course, had already set the direction and in some senses prepared the ground for reaching out to Samaritans. Remember his story of the Good Samaritan, the way that he reached the woman of Samaria, the Samaritan woman at the well, some of the healings that he was involved with, some of the territories that he passed through. But it was still tough and a huge shift in understanding for Jewish believers like Philip to take up this challenge. And even when that happened, that was brought about by persecution, which forced the church in Jerusalem to scatter. It took a lot, but it did happen. And the church grew as Samaritans came to faith. So what do we need to do? Well, I think this morning provides the opportunity to come before God and to name the people groups or individuals that we might struggle with for all kinds of different reasons. And to see if we can find some way of reaching out to them either personally or through a Christian mission that is working with that particular group. I think it might prove to be a game changer if we take this seriously. Lord, in all honesty and openness, I bring before you people that I find it difficult to like or understand. Show me something today that will help me overcome my struggles and to find ways of reaching out to them. In the name of Christ Jesus, amen.
My love.